Well, good evening, Faith Reformed Church. You may have heard at this point that starting on Saturday, we are going to be under a statewide mask mandate for enclosed areas, which is going to include church. And so starting on Sunday, we are going to need to wear masks in church. I know this is a frustration. I know this is going to be difficult for some people. But in many ways, throughout the coronavirus process, as a church, we've had an opportunity to show our commitment to worship. We did it when we were committed to worship through screens early on, as frustrating as that was for a time. And we had a great opportunity to learn how to even improve what we do live stream wise through that process. And we also figured out how to worship as well as we gathered back together and have been meeting row by row and having rows blocked off rather than in every other row. And now we have an opportunity to show our commitment to worship even as we're wearing a mask. I know there's a lot of things going on, both politically, culturally, all those different things are in play right now that bring a lot of frustration, different views, all that stuff. But when we gather on Sunday, even in masks, it's an opportunity for us to show our commitment to gather together and to worship the Father through the Son and in the power of the Spirit. And so that's my hope, is that as we love one another, continue to love one another and lift up Christ, even as we are going to go ahead and submit to our rulers, do what we're called to do for a time, we can also do that in a way that shows our commitment to the Lord Jesus Christ. And so that's my hope this Sunday, even as we have frustrations together about where we're at right now. And so with that said, I also wanted to just point out a few things. If you are singing on Sunday, while you're singing, you don't need to wear a mask. You can take it off while you're singing if you're leading. If you're preaching, that's me. I don't need to wear a mask while I preach. And so I know like I'm the one who's making this statement about how we're wearing masks, and I'm going to be one of the ones that doesn't have to wear it most of the time. But when I'm not preaching, I will still need to be wearing a mask. For those who are going to be doing children's messages, you won't need to wear a mask while you're doing the children's message. And so you get the point. And then also, one of the things too, we don't need to wear a mask while we're eating and drinking. And so we are still going to participate in communion on Sunday, but we'll be able to take off the mask while we partake of the elements. And so one of the things that I wanted to do just briefly is to show you what we're going to be doing for communion. This is all different. This is all weird. This is all how we hope it's not the next time we take communion in October. But just to point out what we're going to be doing, and sorry for this shaky screen, didn't have anywhere to put my phone tonight, but we are having these as communion elements, looks the same. The one difference is going to be that underneath the top of the element, what we have here is the wafer that is on the top. And so what we're going to have is each of these elements will be in the pews in front of you when you come into worship. If you're in the narthex on Sunday, we will get you an element, both the bread and the juice. And it will be in front of you if you're in a pew, and you'll be able to grab it, take off the top, and you'll see the wafer that's on top of the communion, the sealed communion juice. And then what we'll be able to do is you can just pop the seal off and drink it. And what we'll do is you'll have this at the beginning of the service. And then when it comes time for communion, I'll lead us, tell you when to pop the seal off, and we'll partake of the bread together. And then we'll partake of the juice together. And so it's an opportunity for us to, again, even in the midst of everything that's going on, to worship our Lord Jesus Christ, to commune with him. And even it's a wonderful Sunday in the midst of all the chaos that's going on in our country and our world. We can still gather together and show that communing with the Lord Jesus Christ in his presence as his people is the most important thing that we can do this side of eternity. And if you're not able to come still for various different reasons in person, we do trust that you'll be communing with us in spirit as you worship through screens. And look forward to seeing one another, even as we are going through these strange times together. We can be thankful that we're doing so in Christ. Let me go ahead and pray along those lines. And gracious Father, we do thank you for this opportunity for us to show our commitment to Christ more than anything. These times are difficult, they are frustrating, and yet as we look to Christ, we know that we have a Savior who rules and reigns over it all. And there will be a day when we gather around his table and do so without anything as a barrier, whether it's a mask, whether it's our sin, whether it's any sort of disagreement, there will be a day when we are communing in your presence for all eternity around your table. And as we do so on Sunday, even as it is a type and a shadow of the greater feast to come, may we do so with great unity together in Christ, knowing that that is a deeper unity than anything else that we can have in this world. Father, we submit our lives to you, and we pray that we would please you in how we navigate these waters together, for we pray in Christ's name. Amen.